In 1975, a geologic incident occurred at the Mount Baker Volcano in the state of Washington. As, on the morning of March 10th of that year, backpackers and locals alike looked up in horror to see that something significant had changed at the towering, active, glacier-covered stratovolcano. Whereas beforehand, Mount Baker's summit area only occasionally produced faint puffs of gas, there was now a towering plume of white gas which rose several thousand feet into the atmosphere and was accompanied by a notable roaring sound. The U.S. Geological Survey subsequently went to investigate and were also highly concerned by what they saw. At Sherman Crater, the vent which produced every single one of the last 10 of Mount Baker's eruptions, a previously snow and ice-covered vent was now completely devoid of ice and snow, instead being the site of a new crater lake. As they got closer, the strong odor of hydrogen sulfide became detectable, being a constituent of the rising gas plume. Fearing that the Lower 48's first volcanic eruption since 1917 was about to occur, sensors were placed at its summit and areas around the volcano, specifically a 7.81 square mile region, were closed off to everyone with access forbidden. Even Baker Lake was closed, with one of my viewers noting that their family was told to quickly get out as an eruption might soon occur. Due to the danger a future eruption could pose by melting a large section of Baker's glaciers, which could generate lahars, the water level of Baker Lake was reduced by 10 meters or 33 feet to reduce any damage from a lahar which could theoretically occur. As a result, significant tourism revenue was lost in the region as people were fearful of a potential volcanic eruption. Yet, as 1975 turned into 1976 and then 1977, a volcanic eruption did not occur. Instead, the greatly elevated gas emissions began to decrease, with that trend continuing to the present, although such emissions are still higher than they were before 1975 began. The presence of carbon dioxide, and more notably hydrogen sulfide, in my opinion, indicates that whatever caused the geothermal changes in 1975 were supplied these gases from some sort of a magma chamber or magmatic intrusion. So, exactly what happened in 1975 to Mount Baker? Before I discuss the various possibilities on what might have occurred in 1975, here is what we do know. Be sure to pause the video to quickly read over these data points. Here are the current possibilities on what occurred in 1975 at Mount Baker. The first possibility is that the gases were released from still-cooling magma that originally triggered Baker to erupt 9 times during the 1800s, the last of which was in 1880, with these gases suddenly finding a path to the surface which was previously blocked. Thus, no new magma intrusion occurred, and the subsidence merely represented the still-cooling magma, as magma contracts when it cools. Possibility 2 is that a small magmatic intrusion did occur sometime during early 1975, likely before March 10th, possibly involving a 100 million cubic meter body of magma at a depth of 5 to 6 kilometers. Later in the year, once sensors were emplaced, this magma may have simply cooled, causing the measured 8 million cubic meters subsidence, as andesite magma contracts by about 8% when it cools. In other words, uplift may not have been detected simply because low-error sensors were only placed on the volcano after the unusual activity was observed, by which time a magmatic intrusion could have already stalled. Possibility 3 is that no shallow magmatic intrusion occurred, but instead a basaltic injection of magma into Mount Baker's deep underlying magma chamber occurred, which caused a temporary increase in gas emissions, but did not trigger an eruption. With these three possibilities in mind, how close was Baker to an eruption if one of these three was correct? The answer is not any closer than it has been since the beginning of the 20th century for Theory 1, somewhat close to an eruption with Theory 2, and closer than normal but still pretty far from an eruption for Theory 3. In the context of general volcanic unrest, on my 0-10 opinion-based volcanic unrest scale, I would have placed Mount Baker's 1975 activity as a 3. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.